Alright, we're back for the what I would expect to be second to the last turn in August before we begin September of 41. And again, once we hit September 41, we've got some real challenges on our hands as the weather begins to turn. So we're going to run these commandos south. I want them to cut the rail line. Guys over this way, cut the rail line from Archangel. So we're going to run these guys over this way, get this rail line cut. I'm going to launch a second attack to try and pin this unit down from being tactical or local reserve for that particular unit there. And I'm also going to make sure I load up this So we'll use this to try and pin it down so that they can't be a tactical reserve there. Thank you. So you've got a breakthrough here. And these guys are headed that direction. I don't have much in the way of reinforcement coming in, which is how I would normally deal with these guys that are kind of cut off. So again, we're just trying to knock out elements of the Soviet elements of the Soviet line where they've got exposed edges, for lack of a better way to describe it. So we're going to continue to just push west of, push east of Kursk, and up here in Orel. The goal here is to kind of continue to push, provide pressure on Moscow from the south to force the Germans or the Soviets to defend against kind of this entire crescent. Well, in the meantime, you know, we're closing up the elements up north. So we've surrounded and are cutting off and have cut off that that core. By driving this set of units south toward Kharkov, thank you. keep moving these fighters forward. So down here, I'm trying to rebalance the units such that they've got kind of similar nationalities fighting together. As I've mentioned a couple times, one of the elements of gameplay in real life is when you've got multiple disparate units from different nationalities trying to fight together, that it doesn't necessarily go well. Resolve this set and see where we're at. Again, not what I expected there with 100% loss of that Soviet division. I don't expect this to be a successful attack, but it was designed to pin down that hex. Thank you. That I expected to go much better than it did. We got an opportunity, I think, to break through right here. We got not much. Of course, I don't have much on the other side either, but we're coming around from the north. This is a key attack right here up in the north. I'm hoping that by attacking this, these two elements came into play as a reserve there. By attacking here, which was not a very successful attack, they're really bogging down now. Okay, so we've got a few spots where I want to be able, where I kind of want to revisit. Hopefully that takes care of that should take care of that. Thank you. bring these guys in here, then we'll start pushing. But this is... we are just not seeing progress now. Pushing some out here. Okay, let's see what this looks like. Thank you. See if we can get this done. Almost. All right, let's see what the Soviets bring to bear here. That was not unexpected. A company of anti-tank against a division of cav is not going to hold up well. You can see they're starting to move now. They've busted through where I did not have enough adequate strength to kind of bridge. we're seeing an unusually high level of counterattacks. And I have really stretched the entire line thin. In fact, I see a well-borne division here indicates that they've probably reinforced Kharkov. They've pulled some of these troops back, and they're probably going to set up a line in this area here. I got problems. The real issue has been up here in Leningrad. I mean, we were initially extremely successful, but they've reinforced. I haven't been able to bust through those two hexes to get a release the armies south. And now they're starting to bust through across the line. So that leaves nothing between, basically between that division and Minsk, Berlin, Warsaw. Six armored divisions. rough outing.